Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. Today I would like to present our paper with the title Biotechnology Implementation in Crossbreeding between Local and Exotic Cattle at Smallholder Farming Level in Indonesia and their impact on cow reproductive performance. We all know that one of the implementation in biotechnology is a cattle crossbreeding. The crossbreeding is usually done between the local and exotic cattle breeds using artificial insemination. And when it applied in smallholder farmers, which we all know that in Indonesia, in beef cattle breeding in Indonesia, mostly in smallholder farmers was still using traditional management system. So what happened with the reproductive performance of the cow that has a large body frame such as Bram and Cross that reared in smallholder farmers? That is why we did this study to answer the questions. So the materials and method in the study, the location is in Lamongan Regency, East Java, Indonesia. We use 10 Ongol breed cows and 10 Brahman cross cows with the average age of 3.5 to 4 years old and the body weight of 365 to 430 kilogram, and all of the cows were in pregnant phase using limousin semen, and we use also their calves which is Limbra limousin Brahman cross and Limpo limousin Ongol breed from the birth to weaning at 3 months of age. Each cow is placed in a group pen but in position type with the rope individually. And each cow was provided with a feed bunk and drinking water. The study was started by measuring the initial body weight using a livestock and measuring body size. We use height, body length, and chest circumference. And during the study, the cow were fed with 15 kilograms of green grass, 8 kilograms of dry corn husk, and 12 kilograms of fermented corn cobs, and ad libitum drinking water. After calving, the dam and the calf remained together in their housing. And immediately after calving, the calf was weighed. So we observed all the cows that show signs of estrus after the calving. If they show such as secreting mucus, swelling, and redness of the vulva, which is an estrus sign, we will directly inseminate it using limousin cement. After inseminated, the observation was done every day to see if the cow showed estrus again. If there is a sign of estrus, the insemination was repeated. For the calf, immediately after giving after birth, they were weak and kept together with the dam, and every month the calves were weak. We also measure the milk production and the weaning weight at 90 days old. The statistic analysis used in this study for the performance of the cows, we use the p-test and to distinguish the Limbra and Lipo calf, we use covariable or covariance analysis. Here is the nutritional content of the feedstuff. There are three types of feed, which is fermented corn cobs, king grass, and dried corn husk. The table 2 shows the dry matter consumption, crude protein consumption, and total distributable nutrient consumption between two breeds, which is Brahman cross and Ongol breed. In the 3 months of the observation, the results shows no significant difference between two breeds all in the 3 months observation. Discharge shows the reproductive performance of Brahman cross and Angol breed cows. There are some parameters we use, just like days open, service for conception, postpartum mating, postpartum estrus, and pregnant days. The pregnant days show no significant difference between Brahman cross and Angol breed cows. However, the days open and the service per conception, postpartum mating, and postpartum estrus shows significant difference, which Brahman cross showed more days open than the Angol breed, and then more service per conception than Angol breed cow, and then longer postpartum mating and longer postpartum estrus. And we also observe the change in body weight of Brahman cross and Angol breed cows after giving birth. So the first month after giving birth, and then the second month, and then the third month, and also the significant difference in changing of the body weight. Another measurement is the calf body weight and the body size. The figure one is showed the body weight of the calf between the birth, 30 days after the birth, and 60 days old, and weaning week. The birth weight shows no significant difference between the limpo and limpra. However, in the 30 days, first month and the second month, it shows significant difference where the limpra showed bigger body weight than the limpo. It's also shot when on the weaning weight. And then we move on to figure two, which shows the average daily gain of the calf. Average daily gain of the calf from the first month, second month, and the third month shows no significant difference. Only on the third month, it shows a significant difference. The calf body weight and the body size on the figure three, we also measure the body height of the calf. The limbra calf shows a higher measurement than the limpo calf. So the limbra calf is showed better performance than limpo calf. On the body length of the calf, it also shows that the limbra perform better than limpo. In the calf body weight and body size, in figure five, shows that the chest circumference also shows that the limbra performs better than limpo significantly. Conclusion, it was concluded that Angol breed cows was better than Brahman cross in service per conception, postpartum estrus, postpartum mating, and days open. However, the Brahman cross cows better in weaning weight and average daily gain of their calves. Therefore, for the development of the beef cattle in the future, the two breeds of cattle, the Angol and Brahman cross breed, were equally good for breeding. Lastly, we would like to thank Universitas Gadjah Mada for supporting this research through ETA Project 2021, the farmer that already provided all the facilities needed in this study, and the organizing committee of ASNET AIMAC 2022 for giving the opportunity to present this article and all participants who attended this session. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.